Hey, David. Dude, not my face. Sorry about that. I love you.
Why don't you want to see that camera?
Huh? Why don't I want to be seen on camera?
It wouldn't be, he'd get, you know, agitated.
Why is that? Is he wanted by the police or something?
No, he's just, you know, doesn't like it.
Who are you? What's your name?
I'm Chris. Who are you with, by the way?
We're doing, I'm helping him with a school project. He goes to Bridgewater
State. Okay, yeah, you can interview me.
Okay. Well, it's just curious that a lot of you wear masks and cover your faces.
Yeah.
Seems like you're hiding from something.
No, there's a few of us that as a form of protest,
yeah,
cover their face because they're displaying the fact that they don't have an identity, that the government has taken their identity. And I'll, you know, I have no problem, you know, I have nothing to hide. Most people don't have anything to hide here. We're basically fighting for equality and justice because too many people have not been getting the kind of jobs that they deserve. And it's time for us to, you know, really take a stand for that.
How many days have you been standing out for?
I've been here for a week.
All right. And now, do you work at all? Or?
Oh, I've worked at Starbucks. I was a shift supervisor there. I'm a student at UMass Boston. I was on the honor system there, and I saw a lot of the hypocrisy that was going on in this country, and I said I should really do something about it.
So
I don't settle for anything else.
Day to day, right now. I mean, not making money. How are you eating? How are you?
Well, we have a little thing called support, and it comes from everywhere. We make it. We work for it. We have food tents, we have clothing tents, we have medical tents, we have libraries. We have all the supplies that we need, and we work very hard to make sure this place is safe, to make sure that it's clean, to make sure that people are treated with respect and not taken advantage of like they always do in the government.
How long are you planning on staying here?
As long as it takes. I will stay here through the winter if possible, if necessary. To see that our message is heard, and it's heard as loud as possible.
How do you think the government's going to respond to the protests?
Well, we're not really concerned about that right now. What we're really concerned about is doing our activities, spreading our messages, and getting people passionate about the issues.
All right. Very good. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Hey, we need to know.
How long have you been out here?
From day one.
Since day one? All right. How long are you planning on staying out here?
Until it's done.
Now, what do you expect from this whole protest?
I hope that we end up having proper change in the way the situation is, and hopefully we can get these faction bastards the hell out of here.
How are you operating day to day? How are you surviving?
Very carefully. I have one shattered shoulder. I'm all right, though. Basically, I end up doing what I gotta do. I eat, I got my nourishment and everything else, and I just turn back everything I learned, you know, every time.
Any thoughts about the whole protest? What do you expect from it?
I expect some dramatic changes going on, either between the Senate, you know. The way I feel is like we're here for a purpose, and we're not gonna leave. The night we stand divided, we fall, bro.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.